We would love to play first. Yeah, this hand is fine. Not gonna throw it back. Maybe we should have been a little more proactive last game about killing off his Ethereum sculptor. It kind of let him go crazy. But we can learn from that mistake for this game, perhaps. I'm not sure if we want to swamp off of this Dramatic Visions or not. It's not the end of the world to use a Vivid counter for a drag down, and we don't have another, but it would make our future drag down better. I guess we can afford to wait and figure it out. Alright, that's not even remotely scary. If he's not playing any creatures, then we certainly don't have to land cycle now. Like he's just passing, and yeah, I don't think we need to cycle. We might want to counter like one of his come into play guys, like a Fairy Mechanist or a Sanctum Gargoyle. Ooh, all right, don't mind a little Glacial Ray. Hopefully we can find another arcane spell and get our splice on. That would be sweet. Okay, Esperzoa. So he's going to be bouncing his Pyrite Spell Bomb to it. I kind of want to drag that down. I think I want to cycle Fiery Fall more than I want to cycle Traumatic Visions, actually. So we can just pass. I guess we could just play the Latchkey Fairy, actually. And try and trade it for Esperzoa. Yeah, that uses our mana much better. It may compel us to cast to not have Traumatic Visions up next turn if he like plays a Fairy Mechanist or something that we need to forces us our hand at killing Esperzoa so that he can't go off with the Fairy Mechanist. But it doesn't look like that's what he's doing. He's just playing some random duders. Yeah, okay, quite a few random duders, I should say. But yeah, that would be about the same if we had killed Esperzoa or not, unfortunately. That's no help. So I think we just pass here, and we'll probably take a hit from all the guys, and then to hold up Traumatic Visions, and then we can like end step kill off a Frogmite. I think I still want to hold up Glacial Ray. I don't want to use it yet because I really want to splice it. Yeah, I think taking two damage is worth the ability to counter. Like if he plays Sanctum Gargoyle here, we really just need to be able to counter it. Okay. Fiery Fall is acceptable. Probably just going to go ahead and cast that now. That guy out of the way. He'll draw a card in response. I guess maybe looking for a counterspell or something. We take three. Arcbound Worker and Bone Splitter. Alright. And equip. So that's another drag down. So we can drag down, like, both of his modular guys or something. If we need to. We're definitely killing the guy with bone splitter attached. And we're definitely using drag down to do it. We'll see where he places the modular target. Targeting the stinger. I think that's fine. I think we'll just take four, and then we're still hoping to draw another arcane spell to go with our glacial ray. Because that way we can cast both. If it's a Torn of Stone or the other glacial ray, we can kill both his guys, and he doesn't get to trigger modular again. And then we get to save our drag down. Alright, he's got another Frogmite. And moves the Bone Splitter. This is a tough spot we're in. So, on his end step here, we could drag down another Frogmite. No, I don't think we want to do that. I think it's more likely that we're going to draw a land or whatever, and then need to cast Glacial Ray and drag down in the same turn. Yep, unfortunately. So what we're probably going to do is Glacial Ray the Arcbound Stinger, and then drag down whatever he targets with the modular in response. And I guess we're going to... No, we have to do it during combat, or he gets to hit us with the axe again, with the Bone Splitter. Yeah, we really need to draw another arcane spell. Alright, I've had it. There's a few things that just kill us here. I guess we'll start off with the Glacial Ray. Yeah. This way, if he has a Test of Faith, we're not just dead. Although we probably lose if he has that, but this way we don't die immediately. So he targeted that one, so we'll also target that one. Yeah, we need to draw a Mold Rifter, I think. Do not love our spot here. That is not a Mold Rifter. Hopefully Arya's hand is just clogged with red cards and we can somehow kill him before he can cast them. But I'm not overly optimistic. Oh, well, we're just dead to the other Bone Splitter. Alright. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope that my struggling with the beta client wasn't too frustrating, but I think the client is pretty bad. I wish they hadn't forced us to switch. I think they downgraded a bit, and I think it was a foolish decision on their part. But we are dead, so thanks for watching, and check out more videos on Channel Fireball.